So our theme is wisdom, and this quotation is by the Buddha, and he says, "A man is not called wise because he talks and talks again, but if he is peaceful, loving, and fearless, then he is in truth called wise." So that's your assignment for the week. It is to be peaceful, loving, and fearless so you can be called wise. I'm sure you already are. But I just thought that was pretty cool. Being fearless is another way of saying trusting. Trusting the universe, the source, your inner self. So we will do our poses wisely today. So just lifting your spine and just imagine, you know how in some of these beautiful videos when they have all the meditation music and they go from one place to another out in the mountains and all these beautiful places. Just imagine the tall mountain with the waterfall, you know, this long, long, beautiful waterfalls. And just imagine from your occiput down your spine, a huge waterfall bathing all of your vertebra and your discs, all the muscles where they attach to your spine, and just recognize your own beauty with this lovely waterfall cascading down your back. So the waterfall has to land somewhere, either a river or a lake. So just imagine yourself sitting in that body of water. I like to imagine as though walking on water, but sitting on the water. Lotus flowers around, whatever color you like, or maybe multiple colors. And as that waterfall cascades down your back, it washes away any tension or toxins. Imagine your crown chakra opening there at the top of your head, opening like a flower facing up to the sun, and above your head is the sun beaming down into your crown chakra, down into your shoulders, your arms, down into your torso, nourishing all your cells, down into your hips, thighs, your knees, calves and shins, ankles and feet. Now as you sit on this water, we just had a quotation by the Buddha about wisdom. Now imagine yourself as the Buddha, the enlightened one, the wise one. And to enhance your vision of yourself as a Buddha, just bring your left hand in front of your navel and bring your index finger and thumb together and straighten the other fingers out. And then your right hand, bend your elbow and face your right palm outwards. Index finger and thumb together. Bring an inner Buddha smile to your face. Palms into Anjali Mudra, palms touching, and focus in to your breath. Follow your breathing for a few rounds. To your body and sense the sensations in and around your body, muscles and joints, organs, viscera. Listen for any requests your body has. And we'll start with our attunement to breath. your arms up overhead. Nice deep breath. Release stale air on the exhale. Breathe in fresh and breathe out stale or used. One more round. Lift your knees, bring your feet together, holding on to your knees or shins. And this is the solstice, the winter solstice, the longest night of the year. We're about ready to round the corner into more light. So the dark, the luminous dark, is very positive, and we can be grateful for the dark winter nights and mornings, because it does seem to encourage us to focus inward a little more. So as we focus inward, lift in your spine and take in a deep breath, and come into rounded cat as you exhale. Just lowering forward, lean back away from your knees, and then breathe forward, coming into arching cat. And then come to center with neutral spine. And just circle around in your shoulders a few times, breathing them up, exhale down. And if you want to keep your eyes closed on this dark night, long night, reverse your shoulders, circle. Allow the darkness to lull you into relaxation, deeper inside yourself, where you hold your wisdom. Okay, now just bend your knees and bring them into swastika. So your feet will come to your right, and your left hand will be on the mat under your shoulder. And just breathe your right arm up, pull up out of your hips, bend your left elbow, come over into a side stretch. And lift, exhale over. Now this time, if you'd like to come all the way down onto your forearm and stretch away, you can do that too. And just bring your arm up. Breathe. Lengthen. And then hold your pose. Turn your head to look up under your arm. Lengthen. Now just stretch both legs out, still on your left forearm. You can stack your feet or overlap one foot, but just reach through your right fingertips. Press down in your left arm and lift your hips up. See if you can make a little bit of an arch with your hips. And come back down, take in your breath. And exhale and lift, rounding and lowering. Lift and see if you can hold. And lower your hips down. Just lift that top leg up. Reach for it with your right hand. Press through your heel. Just give a stretch to your calf muscle, the back of your leg, your hamstrings. You can also reach for your heel. And then bend your knee, press up, and we'll switch our legs to the other side, and swastika. Palm on the floor, breathe your left arm up overhead, and out. Now this time, lower down onto your forearm. Yes, right forearm and reach. And then inhale. Next to your ear, loosen in your shoulder, let go of burden. And release. Stretch out your legs, overlap your feet. I know some people want to place one in front of the other. Reach through your left fingertips, lift up with an inhale. Reach up, and just work towards a rounded arch. Legs are active. Good. And this last one, we'll come up and hold for a couple of points. And lower down. And just lift your top leg, maybe your left leg, hold on to your toes, your ankle, your heel, whatever you can reach. And flex your foot, give a nice stretch to your calf. Back of your knee. And your strength. And and some hip openers. Up onto the balls of your feet. Rocking forward and back initially. And separate your feet and open. Just bringing in some strengthening for your arms. Palms in front of you, spread your fingers out wide. Your elbows are on your inner thighs. Just lean forward onto your hands. And pull back. Press forward. See if you can straighten your arms. Press the inside of your knuckles down firmly onto the mat. And then come back. And then separate your feet a little further for garland pose or malasana. And from here, I'm just going to suggest that you circle around as you press your knees open with your elbows. Just circle around a few times in your wrists. Then squeezing fingers, stretch up, and then turn your palms facing, bring your thumbs in and wrap your fingers around, draw your thumbs back, wrists, and then press them forward. Coming into malasana, bringing thumbs towards your sternum, your heart center, and just pressing open in your hips, relaxing your groin, your hip joints, lifting your spine. Good. And then bring your palms back. Now, if you have sleeves on, you might want to pull them up because they'll be slippery for this. Bring your palms back onto the mat. Hold on. Somebody. There we go. Okay. So, we come down. Actually, just with your palms on the mat, step your feet apart, lift your heels and bring your knees right up into your armpits. We're preparing for crow pose. Lift your chin and look just beyond you. Lean forward, bringing your hips forward, and then lift. Clothing makes it slippery. And then come down and loosen up in your wrists again. Fingers. And make sure that you've been breathing. All right. So just come up into standing. Get comfortable in your clothes again after rolling around on the floor. separate your feet. And we'll swing in a standing twist. And then come back to center. Drishti to the floor again. Bring your left ankle over your right knee and bend your right knee and just come down into a four square, a standing four square. Flex the top foot, the foot on the bent knee, the crossed knee, and lower your hips down, stay long in your spine. See if you can get your chest down to your legs. And then bring your fingertips onto the mat. Walk your hands forward. Uncross your leg. And hop out into plank pose. Activate your core. Legs, body. And let's just pull back into downward facing dog for a couple of breaths here. Our first one of the night. Hips side to side if that feels good for you. And then bend your knees and hop your feet in. Come into standing once again. Cross your right knee over your left. Flex that right foot and bend in your standing knee, your supporting leg. Lower down into your four square. Press your hips back. If you lose it, just come back in. Take your time. And then reach for the floor. Palms on the mat. Uncross the leg. And hop back into plank pose. Feel the strength in your arms. Know that that energy goes up into your heart. Now, plant the balls of your feet into the mat. Stretch your heels away. Take in a breath. And lift your left leg up as high as it'll go in plank. And switch. Other side. Lift. And lower down. And downward facing dog. Step your left foot forward. Let the back knee down. Come up into the high lunge. Just breathe, arms overhead. Reach up. Pull up out of your hips and out of the supporting knee. Up and back. Give yourself a good stretch here. But elongate in the spine. Don't grind it. Remember that waterfall? Back to center. Take your front foot out a little bit further and come into a deeper lunge. You can relax your arms down. Place your hands on your knee if you want. And if you need to or want to, you can come back into vinyasa a few times. Just inhale it back. And then come into your pose, your legs and hips, and breathe your arms up overhead once again. Reach, bring palms together down in front of your heart, and we'll come into a prayer twist. And optional is to lift the back knee, so you would turn the toes under on the back foot, focus on the spot, and lift that knee up. And come to forward. Bring the back knee down and just switch legs, bringing the back leg forward. Press up, lift your arms up overhead, reach for the stars. Jupiter and Saturn conjoining this very evening. Up and back. Press both feet firmly into the mat. Lengthen the spine. Letting that waterfall cascade down your back like hair, long hair. Forward, take your foot forward a little further, front foot, and come into the deeper lunge, and just bring your palms down onto your front knee. You want your hips facing forward if you can. Good. And then breathe, arms overhead. Palms together down over your heart and a prayer twist on this side. And of course, optional again on this side. Forward, bring the front foot back just a little bit, and step the back foot in. Come in for a head-to-knee pose, or ragdoll, whichever serves you best in this moment. Thank you. And soften your knees and bring your arms out to the side. And gently flow up. Arms overhead. Engage legs and hips. And bring your hands into Kali Mudra. Pointing fingertips up. Index fingers and reach. And we'll come into our tree pose using Kali Mudra for our hands and arms. So just shift the weight onto your right foot and wherever you want to place your leg, or you can come into half lotus if you wish. Just take your time, focus on a spot. And eventually bring your arms into Kali Mudra above your head. And then come out with complete control. Branches come down. Shift the weight to your left foot. Ground into the earth. Just come into your version of tree for tonight. From all the light and come up into Kali Mudra. And release your branches down, step out of your tree. Another standing twist, just letting it all go. And just reflect on what wisdom means to you. What do you think of when you think of a wise person? Or when is it that you feel you're coming from your wise self? All right, so step back on your mat. Step your left leg way forward. Bring your hands down. We'll come into pigeon pose. Come down onto the mat. Oh, doesn't that feel good? Lift in the front of your body. Stretch that diaphragm muscle. Reach back with the back foot. Just press down, lift the heel, and pull into a stretch. Breathe. Keep bringing that back hip forward and lift. Taking your right arm out, inhale, and lift it up, press down on the other arm, lift up and back. And then reach forward, bring your arms parallel in front of you, and just relax in sleeping pigeon. Right, now separate your arms, bring your palms onto the mat. You're just going to switch sides. So bring the back leg around and just swing your legs to the other side. Lift up out of your hips. And then take your left arm, scoop it forward, inhale and breathe it up. And back, wherever your body will go, on this side. And then reach forward. Bring your arms parallel into sleeping pigeon. Just still imagining the sun over your head and the waterfall cascading down your back, still releasing tension, deeper and deeper tension, whatever might be there. Opening the space. There were a physical part where your wisdom resides, where would that be? Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't, but just reflect on it for a moment. Where would it be? Your palms. Just swing the back leg around to the front. Bring both feet onto the floor. Prepare for your shavasana if you want your socks or anything to make you more comfortable. You want to be as comfortable as you can be. What are the qualities of the wise man or woman? Peaceful, loving, fearless. Fearless, trusting. Trust the source. Trust your inner self. Your wisdom. feel peaceful. You feel loving. Are you fearless? Without disturbing yourself too much, just try to bring some little moves into your body. Staying relaxed with your eyes closed, just slide your feet together and lift your knees to your chest and wrap your arms around them. To sitting, and just like we had our mudra in the beginning, bring your left hand in front of your navel, thumb and index finger touching, and then your right hand facing, palm facing forward, also with index finger and thumb together. Affirmation of your Buddhahood. Repeat after me. I am peaceful. I am loving. I am fearless. Resonates for you. And then just bring palms into prayer hands, Anjali Mudra. And may you shine your Buddha light and your Buddha smile from here into infinity. Namaste, everybody.
Thank you for class.
Yes, thank you.